The forecast is for winds between 18 knots, gusting to 22.
1997, Cape Canaveral, Florida. The U.S. Air Force is about to launch its Delta II rocket, carrying a state-of-the-art navigational satellite.
Currently, the launch team is not working any issues.
SSC hydraulic external power on.
Delta Launch Control closely monitors the event.
100% locks.
100% lux topping is reported. We're at T-minus 47 seconds and counting.
45. Main power disable on.
Spirits are high today because this rocket launch will kick off a year-long celebration for the 50th anniversary of the U.S. Air Force.
RCO report range go for launch.
RCO range go.
The rail safety officer reports clear to launch.
All systems check and the countdown begins.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 0, we have ignition and liftoff from Cape Canaveral Air Station of the Air Force Delta II launch vehicle carrying the new GPS-2R satellite. We have had an anomaly. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 0, we have ignition and liftoff.
The U.S. Air Force has just launched its Delta II rocket carrying a GPS satellite. Then, at just 1,589 feet, something goes terribly wrong.
We have had an anomaly.
254 tons of flaming debris shower the landscape.
We just had an anomaly of the Delta II launch vehicle from Cape Canaveral Air Station. This is Air Force Delta Launch Control. We need to secure the area.
The explosion is felt as far as 25 miles away, and smoke from the blast is seen from much of Florida's eastern coast.
We had liftoff 11:22 a.m. of a Delta II rocket, and we did have a major problem.
An investigation reveals that one of the rocket's 9 boosters contained an internal 17-foot crack. This catastrophic defect leads to the explosion moments after liftoff.
We have ignition and liftoff from Cape Canaveral Air Station of the Air Force Delta II launch vehicle carrying the new...
Despite the U.S. Air Force's $95 million loss, no one is injured when the Delta II rocket explodes.
Oh!